Welcome to the another video of Python automation. And here in this, this is the continuation of the another video which we have done to read the data from table of a website. Now in this, we will cover that how to get the data from table to Excel, and second point, how to move to multiple tabs. So I'll just recap the video once again. So in previous video, this was our target website, and we were able to take the data from here and here. So in case if you have not gone through the previous video, I am pasting the link in the description. Please go and watch the video from the starting so that you can connect properly. Now what we will do is that we will take the data as a continuation. We will take the data from here to the Excel. Okay. And so let's go and start working. So here is the earlier code. If you want to see this one by one, these are the first line, first to 16 you can see, and from, and you can understand this code in the previous video. From 17 you can see the code till here, 34, sorry. I will take a pause so that you, if you are typing, you can type it and stop the video. And then from 30th, 33 to end, you can see here. Now point is that we are inside the loop. Okay, here is a loop starting from row 30 and it is ending here. We have to write these values in a Excel file. Okay, so now where we have to perform the action? Within the loop. It should be within the loop. All right. So what is the meaning of within the loop? So if you see the for loop starting from here, you see my cursor, okay, from here, and it is coming to this side, and then you go down, down, down this side, and it is ending here. So if you want to see really the end, for loop ends here. All right. So this is the intent. This is the body of this for loop. There is one intent you can see. I hope you understood this. So now whatever action we will perform here, we will write. So to write the code, I will be using open py Excel. If you are not aware with the library, I have given a video there in my description. You can see how to automate Excel. By that you will understand how this library will work. Okay. All right. And so to start with, first we need a Excel file first of all. Okay, so inside that Excel we will be writing. So now if that you are trying to keep this inside the project folder, okay, I can browse the project folder from left hand side, Python project. Okay, and I will create a new file over here, or I can just open the location from here, open in Explorer. I have it here, Python project. So my script into this folder only, so I will better create the file in this folder. And now I will create web data output. I will copy this name from here. After creating the file, what is the next step? That I have to initialize Excel. So here, this is the code for browser. This is the code for browser. And here I am starting. So before I am opening the URL, so before opening the URL, okay, before opening the URL, I will initialize the Excel here. I will explain you the entire code, so you don't worry that code is looking very huge. Here, open py Excel, I have to import open PY Excel. I have already installed this. How to install the library, you can see a video on my YouTube channel. Alright. And the second option is that I have to always take the maximum row, okay, because I have to write the data. So about OpenPY Excel and how to automate Excel, you can again watch the video first, then you will understand this code better. But even if you don't want to watch, you can understand from here itself. So first thing is, let me deactivate this code as of now. Okay. So now first point, whenever I will write the row, I will write the row from the next row of the maximum row. So let's say if I already have 5 rows, so maximum row is 5, now I have to write the data into 6 row. In OpenPY Excel, so first of all, we are reading the Excel sheet from here, and then we are loading the data from Excel sheet, and then we are loading the data from file. This is Excel file, basically, not sheet. File, and this is we are not looping here. Get the sheet to work. So if your sheet name is something different, you have to write the same sheet name over here inside this. Okay, and then last row, this is a variable which I am creating now. So last row of what? Datasheet dot max row. This is max. So this is like this, I guess. Let me check now. Yes, so we can access the last row is 1. Okay, so now we are done. Alright, so this code is not required. And I will just move this code one more line above from opening the browser. Let me keep it separate. Here. Okay. And browser code is going now. Where I have to write the data? Come inside. Here I have to write the data. So we have initialized the file, okay, and then we have initialized the row. So, but we have to read this row inside the loop, because when I will write column row number 1, then the count will be 1. When next loop I am coming, then I will write the row once again. So this row has to come inside of the loop. Okay, so I will go inside the loop. And this loop is for what? Web tables. You will understand from my previous video. Okay, so now we have the maximum row. Now how to write the data in the cell? That's the question. Alright, so I have taken the code here so that I can save your time. So last row we have already taken from the sheet, and then data sheet. Data sheet is my sheet where I am working. You can go and check once again. Where is the data sheet? Here. Okay, you see row number 13, 13. Okay, and now when I am writing the data back to datasheet, column number 1 and last row plus 1, because always I have to write in the next row. Okay, so city name and then column number 2. I want to write project name. and then data file. So this is not data sheet focus, data file dot save. All right. So you can save, and then you can save one backup file also, so that if backup and give some delay between both the files, your solution will be little slow, okay, but you will not lose the data in case if something wrong happens and you are running the a big file. One second, you just keep, so that these both the files will be keep saving. All right, so now you are aware of the data and how does it works. Now let's run this code. Let's go and check what has happened. See, one by one everything is going on after one second. Okay, we will close all the windows first, and then we will go in the project folder, and then we will see web output, and then you see there are two different files. Okay, now I will open first file. So you can see the first is Jaipur, and then so this is for header. Actually, I have not written the header now. So what I will do is I will write CITUSFT name, and then I will just do some color here, and then I will write what is this project name. Project name, and then I will copy the format from here to here, and then just change the font color. I will remove this data. Now I will save the file, Control S. I will close this file, and I will delete this file. Okay, now let me run the code once again. Let go back to the left. So it's opening the website. Things are happening in backend. If you want to see, you just see here. It's open, and now it will start working on the site. Is loading now. Loaded. Now it will start working. Okay. Come down. Come down. It's happening automatically, so you understand this is happening slow because we have given 1 second delay. Okay, now we will see the code file once again. What is the so here is the web output backup and web output. Now let's open the file once again. So file has come in proper format. So you see the format of the file is proper. I hope you understood how to take the data back from table now. Now next thing is that how to handle multiple tabs. So whenever you will click on a button which is there on the website, then there will be a different tab getting open. Okay, so to click on the tab or to move on the tab, I just show you first of all. So we will click every time this, and then this new tab will open. We will take this project, not project name, we have already, we will take this registration number. Okay, and then we will write it back to the data. Alright, so first thing is that we have to handle the windows. So how to handle the window, I'll just explain you. Have to work on handler, window handler. So windows handler is something in Selenium which will handle multiple windows together at one time. So if we see our code, the loop is starting from here. So we have to put entire code in the loop, as I told you just now. So somewhere here we will put the code, and but before that we have to just see how it will work. So just for testing, what we will do is we will write some code for testing, and then we will move that code inside the loop. So for testing purpose, we have to open the browser and then we have to click. So what I will do is I will create some space here. Okay, here. So after opening the browser, I'll just create some area. Okay. Code. And I will upload this file somewhere on Google, and then I will share the link so that you will have entire code available, because this will be a little long file, but you should understand everything step by step. Okay, first of all we will take the current window handler, or we will say main page driver dot current window handle. So what we have done is we have taken the reference of our present window, because we have to come back on this window after working on new window. All right. Now, what we have to do is that we have to loop through all the open windows, okay, which are currently open. So how to do that? First of all, we have to take count of present windows is equals to, that will be, so we will take length. My driver dot window handles. So this will give us the count. Okay, I will mention here count of all open windows. Okay, and after that we will loop through all open windows. So why we are looping? Because we have to go to each of the window and see where our title or something is matching. Okay. So I will take a index, win index means window index. Index in count of present windows, and then I will just print the title of all the windows. Driver dot switch to, so first I will switch to the new window, and then I will window handler and then which window I have to switch, this window. So this is the list of all windows, and this is the index or the serial number of a window. So I will move to all the windows one by one, okay, by using this code, and then I will check what is the title. Okay, so first let's, I will not go there, I will first check the title here. Title. Okay, now and I will exit this code here so that it is not, the program is not executing completely. We just wanted to test this part and then after we will move. So from here the code is starting. Okay, so let's try running this now. Now let's go to the project. So one small correction I must to mention range here. Okay. So you see the title is coming here. Okay, so now we are able to access the title. So if you see in this window, the page which is opened, we have to first click on this. After click only, we will be able to check that yes, if we are able to access the title of the new window which is opening here. So what I will do is I will just make a temporary code to click on this one and Control Shift I, same formula which we have been using from long, and then I will search for this. It's not allowing, so I will manually type view. Okay, so this is the header. We will not go for this. We will need to go for the row, inside the row. So here is it is inside the row. So if you put your cursor, you can see the cursor is coming inside the row. So just notice this, don't go for this one. Okay, go for this one and then you copy the XPath. After copying the XPath, so what we have to do is after storing this main window, we have to open new window. Okay, so how will we open that? We have to click. Okay, and then I have created frame element. Click. So we will click and then we will wait for, I am just mentioning 4 seconds. You can mention 5 seconds or 10 seconds. Okay. So once we will be ready with the code, we will move the code inside the loop. Okay, and I will upload this file as I just said on Google, so you will have the file ready. But you should understand things, how these things are happening, otherwise there is no point to, you know, copy and paste the code. Now new window is open, so we will see if there is a difference in the two titles. So now we will go and check. There is some issue here. 26. Oh, time dot. So I am putting some wait here so that the new window can open. I am putting just 3 seconds. You can put as per your. Okay, so now click is done. After click, what I am doing, I am putting after clicking the button, I am just putting some wait time. Okay, time dot sleep. You can put 4 seconds, 5 seconds, whatever you want. And let's close all existing windows. And then run the program. So we want to see that the new window is getting open or not, and code is able to access both the titles or not. So there are two different windows you can see. Okay, so now let's go and check. So there are two different titles. The first, this is the main window title and this is the another window title. So what we can do is we can create a condition now that if title consists this registration number, RERA registration number, then you move to other window. Okay, now how to do that? Just simple code writing we have to do now. If so, we'll go here and we will check. This string or this text exists in, so how will you do in Python is like this. So in str my driver dot title, okay, and then code to perform your action. So what we are doing, I will explain again. So this is the count of windows which are open. Okay, so let's say we have 10 windows open. So this is a single window. Win index is a single one window count, and then we have to loop through all the range. Let's say this is zero, for example, because initially it will be zero only, and it will loop through, and there are 10 windows open, so it will loop 10 times. What will it do 10 times? It will just go to, from here, it will switch to first window, it then it will switch to second window, it will switch to fourth window. So when it is switching to different windows, we have to check that the window which is there, okay, so this in the title, this is existing or not. So if this is existing, then you do click or then you do whatever you want. Okay, so as of now, what I will do is I'll just try to take some data from there. Okay, what data we can take? So we will take this registration number only, as I had just mentioned earlier. So this is not happening. If I am trying to right click, Control Shift I, and then we will go RAJ, we will search here. I will zoom it for your quick reference, right? And then Control F R A J. I think the before one, so you can move up and down from here. So I think this is the element which we need. Yes, this is the one. You, when you move the cursor, you will understand. Now you can just copy the X path from here. X path is here. And then you can create path for registration is equals to this. All right, and then this is not good XPath basically, but now you know that how to create a strong XPath. So you can try with the formula which I have explained in my video. Okay, so here is the formula which you can see over here. You use this and then create some XPath. It will take a little time, so I am not doing it. I have done it many times in this video and the previous video also, so you can have a look on that. And then we will create, like, we need a text, like registration number. I just make a add regnum is equals to driver dot find dot text we need, and then for now we will just print the registration number. Registration number is plus str registration number. Okay, now let's try to run this code. We'll close the existing window. Yes, so we are able to take the registration number you see on the page. Alright, so this is how we will extract. Now the point is we have to write this data back and we have to close the window which is open now. So what we will do is we will close this window once we have copied the data. So how do you close the window? As of now my driver is where? On this. Let's say if this is on 10th or this is on 7th, but whichever place. But my driver is on the same. So what I have done is I have stopped the loop here with condition and then I am performing the condition. After that, I want to close this driver where I am now. Okay. So close details window. So presently I have on details window only. So how will I close driver, my driver dot close, and then my driver dot switch to where? Previous window, main window, you can see here we have taken main page. You can see like main page underscore window. All right, so I will just move back because I have done my job there, whatever I wanted to do. Switch to this one. Okay, and then again in the loop will start, loop will move to the next clicks. So let's try this, and then if it is working successfully we will move the code inside for loop. There is a mistake, small mistake, driver dot switch to. Okay, so to move on, yes, so to move on the main window is like dot window. Now this will this should work. So if the code is working, I have closed the existing window. So if the code is working, we will move the code inside new window. All right, let's try this now. We will see. Yeah, so code is working fine. So the window is, the other window which was child window is closed and we are back to the new window. So if we will click on the next one, then we will open the next one. We will close this one and then we will go to the next. So this is how we have to do, and we have to write the data back into Excel. So you can take a snap of this this part. Okay, now this part we will move inside because this will happen all the times for all the rows which are available. So we have to move this code inside the for loop. Here we go, and then we will remove this. You can have a look back on the code which you have seen from start of this program. Here are libraries. Okay. And this is the code, and from here we are opening and loading the project page, and then we are looping through all the windows which are there on the all the rows which are there on the. So now till here we are writing, you see, we are writing the data back to Excel. Okay, But before that, we will write this code where we are opening the window all the times and we are copying the registration number. Details action, and then we will paste that same code here. Okay, in details window action. Alright, so this is a again for loop inside the for loop. So what we have to do now, here we are clicking only on the one button, but once we are closing, every time we have to close which button? So you remember this counter from my last video of this project only. So this counter will change all the time. Okay, let's just go back to memorize. So this is the row counter which will change all the times, and then I have a city name in column 2, but a row counter will change, and I have a project name in column 4, but row counter will change. Alright, now I need to click the button with the same row. Okay, I have to copy this code from here. Alright, and inside this one we have to replace, because this should change, row should change all the times. Okay, call quotes and then paste it. Alright, now we have the registration number from so you can just remove this print. There are so many prints. Okay, here is the registration number which we require, and then after registration number we will close the window and we will come back to main close child window, or you say detail. And here how many okay, so you will understand this code one by one. Loop to all open window. If title perform the action, whatever you want to do. All right. So this commands I have written. Code is looking like little not good, but I have mentioned everything so that you can understand the code line by line. Now. So this registration number we have to write in the third row, for example. So what we will do is, we will just copy this and paste the code. The rest of the code we have already written, and we will change the column number here. We will make it 3, and then we will make this registration number. So let's go to the Excel now. So here is the Excel. I will open this one is the Excel. Change, this is registration and MDER. Just we will do this formatting, that's it. And then we will delete all existing data. Save the file, close the file. I will explain you the code and then I will paste also, so don't worry about the code. And these are two different videos. So you have to watch first one and then second one, then only you will understand complete work. I will close the existing one and then I will start the program. okay, second window, close second window, third window, close third window, fourth window, close fourth window. So you see, it will happen 10 times because there are 10 different rows on the first page, and I have, after 10 rows, I have broken the loop. If you will see my previous video, you will understand this, how it is happening. So we will do this only 10 times. So you see, it is happening for all. Registration number is changing. If you want, you can just go back in the video and check that the registration number was changing all the times. And then we will see the video here. And you see, I just upgrade this file. So this is coming from first video and first page, this page. Okay, you see. अकल का होना भी किसी किसी में होता है सच में। ये काम बहुत आराम से भी किया जा सकता था। So you can see this data here. I'll just open the web now and we will match the details one by one. So you see the first index is Jaipur and then this is the project name. Okay, Jaipur project name and registration number is this one. Okay, so now let's go and check first one. It's here. Okay, you can see, and I will open the Excel also for your perfect match. One sec. So we have Excel here. You can check. This is the detail. And then we will go to the second one. We will check Jaipur Mahima Uday and then view. This is the 84 is the registration number. Let's go to the Excel now. 84 is the registration number, Mahima Uday, and here it is. Okay, we will go to last. I will not take much of your time. Last on this page. You can just match it from here. Okay, and then Surabhi phase fourth. Surabhi phase fourth. Okay, so this is how you do things. I will upload this data and then let me re-explain you once again. I'll just go quickly. So these are all the things which we require, all the libraries which we have used in this program. And you can see the code till line 18th. You can focus on the code. So I will just hold this one. After that, I am creating an Excel file where we have to write the data. And then I am loading that Excel file because without load, I cannot write the data. And then I am, this code is to initialize the Excel sheet where we have to write the data. And then this is about the browser. So we have to open the browser. We have to start the browser, maximize. And then we have to add that maximize option to our browser variable. Okay, you can see comments here. And then this I am opening. This is just a syntax which I have told so that you can understand how to create XPath. After that, we are opening the site over here. And then we are checking, ensuring here that yes, site is properly loaded or not. Okay. By checking that yes, one element is ready or not. So this element we are checking that yes, if element is there, then it means site is successfully loaded. Now next point is that we have to go through the table. So here I am accessing the table, okay, with this code. This is a table XPath, and then after accessing the table, I have taken list. So you again focus here, find elements. It is not single element, it is elements. Okay, so not element. So we are taking all list of all the rows and then we are moving to rows one by one. So if you want, you can now, you want, you can comment this counter line. It is not required. This also you can comment, or you can delete this line. This we have kept only for our testing. So I will keep this, but in your code, you can just remove this. This is not required once the program is running successfully. Now what we are doing is that we are opening the view again and again, and then new window is getting open. Okay, and then we are looping through. So let's say once I have clicked view, so there is a new window open. So I will loop through all available windows. So from here you can understand, first I have stored the main window address to come back, because we have to come back after we have performed the task. We have to come back to the same window. So we have taken some variable so that we can easily come, and then we have click on the button, view button. Okay, so here is the view button XPath, and then we have click on view button. View button is opening new window, and then we are identifying the window by title. After identifying window by title, we are performing the action, and then we are closing the new window. We are coming back to the previous window, I mean the main window. And then we are writing all the data which we have taken in these three steps here. Okay. And then we are writing the data back to Excel, which we have taken from here, number one, here, number two, and then number three from here. Okay. So here we are writing the data back, and then we are saving two different files. After that, we are closing the, so if the row, next row is not available, we are ending the program there. You will understand everything in detail if you will watch both the videos. I am pasting the link in description. I will upload this code file in Google and share the link to you. Thank you very much for your time. I hope this was helpful for you. Please share the link to your friends, to or your colleagues, or to all the team members to whom this can be helpful. Thank you very much.